This story begins with a little girl born in a beautiful village on a mountain in Lebanon. From a young age, she learned infinite kindness from her mother and unshakable integrity from her father. The years to come will be defined by her search for a home, a place furnished with love and belonging. I remember once my father took me on a visit to his friends who lived about an hour outside of our village, and I was about this small. I remember that they looked different, they spoke differently, they had different religious beliefs, and that's something I always admired about my father. He didn't divide people based on labels. Integrity was the most important thing to him. I don't remember exactly how the conversation went, but I remember one moment during that conversation. I told him how my classmates made me feel small because I believed that people could not do wrong because they wanted to. They called me naive. And this might sound cheesy, but he turned to me and said, "Your little toe is more worthy than all of those people who make you feel that way." I carried that moment with me in my heart wherever I went for a very long time to this day. Every time someone made me feel small, I remembered my father's words. Over the years, I continued to learn kindness from my mother through her actions and integrity from my father through his actions. And I learned along the way that that combination makes for a very lonely road, and belonging becomes harder and harder to find.
يلا تنام ريما يلا يجي هالنوم يلا تحب الصلاة she will touch it, she will help that mission. She kill
The only medicine I need are the arms of my mother.
Thank you.
had no home, and with that I was content, because I never knew what it felt like to feel like home. So you built a home for me, and I finally felt like I belonged. All of my scattered pieces suddenly came together. Somewhere I put my heart to sleep as you cradled my worries away. I woke up one day, cold, abandoned, without a roof on top, without windows or walls, without you. And you wonder why I am unable to let you go. Before you, I never knew what a home was. You gave me a taste of heaven, and with your hands you took it away. Once you enter heaven, you can never live again the same.
يابا شوفني النمرة وحبيت الأسد يابا بس القلب اللي بيصلي القلب اللي بيصلي يا با القلب اللي
16 years old, and my search for a home came to a halt as my search for belonging ended. Years later, I became a teacher, and my first students were a group of young refugees who sought refuge in Canada from a war-torn country. I remember looking at them and seeing my 16-year-old self. And I just knew I had to tell them, me too. I understand. You belong here. That belief in kindness and goodness was awakened, and that led me to the arms of those who knew that little girls like me existed, and parents like mine who would teach me the lessons that they taught me existed. They built a home for me that looked like it was filled with love and belonging, when it was really filled with lies, deceit, and abuse. It turns out that when you search for home in people, you give them the power to make you homeless. This girl, no longer so little, could no longer see life the way she once saw it. The pain planted in my heart was so heavy as mountains. I didn't know where to go to, or who to go to, or whether this journey was worthy of being continued. The road was too dark, and home was nowhere in sight. I asked myself, where do I belong? With whom do I belong? Do I deserve to belong?
In all where I where them feel el يملو الروح دموع يا حبيب القلب
النار ولا عش ولا دم في القلب يملو الروح
Do you know what it feels like to be put on a racetrack and told to run and run and run with no end in sight? Do you know what it feels like to continue on a road that you know has no destination, just because you're afraid of not having any other road if you left the one that you're on? Do you know what it feels like to be forced to jump off a cliff, knowing that you have no wings to lift you? Do you know what it feels like to shout and scream and yell your heart out, knowing that everyone is listening but pretending not to hear? I do. Do you know what it feels like to believe that you are a mistake, and that feeling pain means that you have no control of your feelings? Do you know what it feels like to be given the shovel to dig deeper and deeper, only to find out when it's too late that it's for yourself, and that there's no one waiting to lift you out of the hole? Do you know what it feels like to fight a battle with no possible pain inflicted upon anyone but yourself? Do you know what it feels like to be wounded and told that you caused the wound to yourself by choosing to be where the harm landed? Do you know what choking on injustice feels like? Do you know what it feels like to know that silence is your best choice when your words can no longer be held inside of you as a hostage? I hope you never know that feeling, because that is how you made me feel, and I would never wish this kind of pain upon anyone.
Thank you.
Just because you're feeling lost, it does not mean that you need to go back their way, even if they were the only home you've ever known. You left it for a reason, remember? It's better to stay lost and search for a home than to return to the home that was never really a home. Build your own home.
Thank you.
The tears storming in my heart woke me up as the night sky rained invisible threads like the ones you weaved. They asked me, what would you tell your daughter if her heart cries this way over a man one day? That is when I knew every answer I needed to know.
Thank you.
One night before my father left to Lebanon, he sat with me and reminded me of a picture where I was this small and I was holding his hand very tightly. And he said, "When I used to look at you when you were that small, I looked at your eyes and I would think, this girl is going places. And now that look is gone. I remember that night looking in the mirror and seeing someone who didn't resemble me. This is not me. This looks nothing like me. This looks like a sky choking on clouds or rain, not knowing what to do." And that was the beginning of my awakening. The darkness began to fade away the moment my search for a home ended. Something magical in my heart sparked like fire. And when my search for a home ended, when I realized that the home that I've been searching for is nowhere further than within myself, tears upon tears to cleanse my soul, I said to myself, "I belong here. I belong within my own soul. Welcome self-forgiveness. Welcome self-acceptance. Welcome self-love. Welcome belonging."
Take off your wings, it's time to fly.
Thank you for silencing me. You led me to break the silence of thousands who've met humans like you, who chose not to use their hearts to love, to allow their consciences to be just, or their broken pasts to heal the wounds of the broken. Thank you for loving me only when you needed someone to love you. You led me to understand that in times of our need for love, our hearts are the most beautiful. Thank you for leaving me when I needed you most. You led me to myself. You led me to believing in my own heart. You led me to my voice.